My name is Eric. I'm one of the recruiting coaches here at Captain U. And each and every week, we spend a little bit of time talking about recruiting. Tips, tricks, feedback, different content. And today, we are talking about how you should look at recruiting if you are a junior or a senior. So if your athlete is going into their junior year, their senior year, or you just want a heads up on some strategies to come, then today is for you. So let's go ahead and dive on in. And like I said, today we are talking about recruiting for juniors and seniors. So tw those 2022 grads, those 2023 grads, what are the special things that you want to consider if you fall into those grad years? So but we'll talk about an outline of what we are talking about today. There we go. Now my camera is set. We're going to talk about peak recruiting, which is, hey, what are kind of the key things to think about? And what do we call peak recruiting? What is the period when most athletes are working on recruiting, when most of the kind of real meat of recruiting takes place? We're going to talk about the key steps involved once you are in your junior and your senior year. We're going to talk about some high-level strategy that you can employ as you connect with coaches and work on recruiting. We're going to talk about what makes you a great recruit, which is very important to understand if you want to have effective recruiting conversations. We're going to talk about your colleges list and some considerations when it comes to choosing what schools you're focused on. And then we're going to close out with some tips for conversations. But with that, let's go ahead and dive on in. Okay, so first I want to talk about peak recruiting. Because there's a lot of misinformation out there. I hear all sorts of crazy things. Sometimes I'll be on the phone with a freshman, and their parent will say, "Gosh, we feel like we're so far behind. We're already hearing this and that, and somebody committed here." And just to set the record, peak recruiting is the summer before your junior year, maybe about midsummer, to kind of late winter or early spring of your senior year. This is when most folks are thinking about recruiting, are working on recruiting. This is when a lot of the regulations have dropped and you're allowed to have real recruiting conversations. Of course, hey, for lower division schools, that's going to be, you're going to have be able to have conversations even earlier than that. But for the most part, when we talk about peak recruiting season, we are talking about the summer, maybe like July 15th before your junior year, to let's go ahead and say like maybe March 15th of your senior year. That is, if you are in that area, then you are, really at a time where recruiting should be part of your weekly progress. Just like you're working in the classroom, just like you're working in your sport or staying in good condition for your athlete, you should be working on recruiting, putting an hour a week on the calendar or 2 hours a week on the calendar and spending that time working on recruiting. It is worth noting that these days, proactive exposure is the best exposure. You'll hear me say it time and time again if you've been watching these live sessions, but there's no better way to get your foot in the door than to knock on it yourself. And so during this peak recruiting season, you should be researching your schools, researching, what colleges are going to be a good fit for you and what programs are going to be a good fit. Should be sending messages out to those coaches. You should be managing all of your athletes' content, pictures, videos, stats, awards. We'll talk about all this stuff specifically, but during peak recruiting, especially, it is not the time to be sitting around waiting for coaches to come knocking on your door. It's very important to stay organized, to be prepared for conversations if a coach does reach out to you, and to be consistent in making your recruiting progress. There's no secret to it. There's no magic to it. It's the athletes that are being proactive, consistent, and organized. Those are the athletes that are going to end up with the most options. So, the last thing here before we move on is don't wait for recruiting to happen. This is one of the biggest mistakes. If you went through recruiting 15, 20, 30, 40 years ago and you're helping somebody out with recruiting, it is a very different ball game. Even in the last 5 years, even since I started at Captain U about 8.5, 9 years ago, it's a very, very different world. And so make sure that you are putting aside some time to actively work on recruiting. It's going to give your athlete much more opportunity. And especially if you are a rising junior, if you're a rising senior, this needs to be part of your weekly habits for your athlete. Okay, so what are the key steps? If I need to be working on recruiting, what are the key steps that you actually need to be working on? And the very first step is building out your profile and cataloging your recruiting content. You know, basically, step zero, I like to say, is thinking about what makes you a great recruit. We're going to talk about that in the next slide, but really getting a handle on what is it about me that coaches are going to be interested in. And you need to have some ways to show that to coaches. So, you know, building a folder or, you know, a file somewhere, you know, maybe you have a Google Drive, maybe you organize it on your Captain U, maybe you have a folder on your computer, maybe you have a scrapbook, but keeping everything somewhere, your pictures that maybe you get action shots at games, maybe you have training photos, maybe here's holding up an award or a trophy, you know, your video for some sports, this is going to be more important than others, but video is always something coaches like to see. Collecting your stats, if your team takes stats, great. If they don't, maybe finding some ways to demonstrate the key things you want coaches to know about. Your awards, your academics, did you show up in a newspaper article? Oh, really getting everything together and making sure that a coach can see exactly why they should be interested in your athlete through your Captain U profile is the very first step you need to be working on. You're going to show up higher and more often in search results if you have a good profile on Captain U. And if you get out and start being proactive, there's going to be something for coaches to actually see. So this is the absolute baseline first key step you should be working on. It's building out that profile and cataloging your athlete's recruiting content. The second thing is you need to build and maintain and review your athlete's colleges list. You know, I always like to say, there's no better way to get your foot in the door. There's no better exposure than recruiting exposure. You've heard me say these things time and time again, but it's hard to be proactive if you have no idea who your athlete wants to speak with. If you don't know what types of schools are going to be a good fit, you need to spend some time to think about this. So we'll elaborate on that a little bit, but in terms of a key step, you got to build and maintain that list. And I think if you are in your junior year, 10 to 15 schools is a good place to be. If you're in your senior year, maybe 5 to 10 schools is a good place to be. Maybe we've narrowed it down a little bit by then. And then lastly, we want to start and maintain conversations with the coaches at the schools that interest your athlete. Again, we got to be pushing ourselves forward. You know, if you're not out there introducing yourself to coaches, you can bet that your competition is. So we're going to spend a little more time talking about messaging here in a couple slides. But those are the key steps. Build and maintain your profile, build and maintain your list of schools, and, you know, get into conversations with coaches, build rapport, get them the information they need, maybe try and set up, you know, evaluations or camps or, hey, come watch me play. You know, it all comes from putting in this effort. You know, each step is not that complicated, not that difficult. You know, none of this is rocket science. It's all just having an understanding of what makes you a great recruit, finding some ways to demonstrate that to coaches, thinking about what makes a school a good fit for you, building a list of schools that match that fit, and then having conversations with those coaches. That is a summary of the entire process. If you can hit those couple things, you are going to be on the right track. You're going to be building exposure rather than waiting for it. And your athlete is going to have way more opportunity than just the average person who says, hey, I'm going to play my sport and wait for coaches to come knocking. Okay, so overall strategies, if you are a junior or a senior, first of all, again, highlighting my favorite quote, there's no better way to get your foot in the door than to knock on it yourself. I drill this into the athletes that I'm working with. If you've been a longtime watcher of Captain U Live, you've heard me say this. It's that important. Being proactive is how you get maximum exposure with college coaches. Other strategies. Shorter contacts more often, I find, is a great way to kind of build up some momentum. You don't have to put so much pressure onto every single interaction. When you're sending your first message out to a coach, your first follow-up, you're sending a check-in, you don't need to spend hours and hours and hours on these messages. Now, do I think that you should just write a one-sentence thing and copy and paste it to every coach in the country? No. But the fact is, you don't get recruited in a single message, a single interaction, a single video view. You get recruited as your build rapport with coaches over time. So buckle in for the long haul. Make sure that you are being consistent, and that is going to get you a lot more looks. You're going to get that name recognition. So even if a coach doesn't catch, even if your messages don't catch a coach perfectly at any given time, one, you are going to get that name recognition from showing up in their inbox over and over again, and you're giving yourself more opportunities to catch the coach at the right time. There is a story I've shared quite often, is I was interviewing a college coach who, or not a college coach, a parent of an athlete who committed to a D1 school, about a year, maybe 2 years ago. And a quote that parent told me, I've been sharing with all of my athletes. They said, there's a fine line between being persistent and being pushy. Don't be afraid to walk that line. Sometimes you just got to catch a coach at the right time. And athletes that are worried about bothering a coach and, oh, I don't want to send a follow-up, I don't want to hurt my chances, they miss a lot of opportunity where maybe a coach, they just didn't catch them at the right time, or the coach was considering someone else and they changed their mind. Don't be afraid to be persistent. You don't want to bother coaches. You don't want to send them messages 10 times a day. But if you haven't heard back for a week or 2 weeks, there's nothing wrong with following up. Another strategy, always engage the coach further. You should never just answer a coach's question and then hope that they're going to pick the conversation back up. You need to be engaging coaches, asking questions. Always, I would say, just as a rule of thumb, ask a question at the end of every interaction. Hey coach, I filled out your recruiting questionnaire you sent over. Do you have any camps coming up? The coach replies, hey, thanks for your question. I've got a camp on this date. And you say, wonderful. I'd love to come to the camp. Is there anything I should do to prepare? And the coach says, maybe you do this to prepare, this, that, and the other thing. And you say, hey, thanks so much. I'm definitely going to work on that. Here's my video. Can you give me some feedback? Every time you have an interaction with a coach, you are setting up an expectation of further interaction. You're building rapport. You're letting this coach get to know you. That's what I mean by always engage the coach. Always end your messages with a question. It's one of the easiest, most simple things you can do to foster a lot more exposure. Another strategy, always be honest and straightforward with coaches. I sometimes find, people think that coaches are trying to pull a fast one, or I don't want a coach to know that I'm talking to other schools, or, I don't want a coach to know about other opportunities. I find if you are honest and straightforward with coaches, you will get the same in return. Now, is that always going to be the case? Maybe, perhaps not. Maybe some coaches, have something in the works that they don't feel comfortable sharing. Maybe they're moving schools or something like that. But I find for the most part, if you are honest with coaches about why their program is a good fit for you, why you're a good fit for their team, and you're being straightforward about it, coaches want somebody that they're going to be able to get along with, that they're going to be able to coach well. And if you're letting your personality come through and the things that are important to you come through in your conversations, it's going to be much more natural, much more confident, and much more impressive to coaches. And lastly, be consistent with your content and your profile. This is a big mistake I see athletes making, is they put all this effort into their profile and then they never come back to it again. Make sure you're keeping that up to date. A coach wants to recruit your potential of who you will be and who you are becoming, not who you were 6 months ago, not who you were 2 years ago. Don't build out a great profile and never touch it again. My recommendation is at least once a month, add some new piece of content to your profile, whether it's a picture, a video, a coach endorsement, a status update. Make sure you're keeping that up to date. Be consistent with it. Coaches want to see fresh information. You're going to show up higher in searches. You're going to show up in their feeds. There's going to be more for them to see when you do get their attention. You're totally setting yourself up for success the more consistent you are, not just in your conversations, but also with keeping your profile and your content to date. All right, wonderful. So let's move on to what makes you a great recruit. I think there's really two things to understand. We're going to talk about it in this slide and the next. Before you can have successful recruiting conversations, you need your athlete to know these two things. And the first is what makes you a great recruit. Who are you and why should a coach care? I know that sounds a little bit harsh, but it's important to have an understanding of what your key strengths are, and you need to have some ways to demonstrate those strengths. And what I'm talking about here is not stats, it's not awards, it's not evidence of skills. You need to know the skills. So if your athlete is a super physical player who's not afraid to run people over, or maybe they have a high IQ for the game and they can really read their opponents. Maybe they're the hardest worker. Maybe they're the fastest, the strongest, the best student. Think about what those strengths are and then find ways to demonstrate those strengths. That's what we're going to fill the profile with, is evidence of your strengths. But it is important that you don't just get in there and start posting everything for the sake of posting things. You want your profile to tell a story of an athlete with a few key high-level skills that you want shining through. You want your messages to tell a coach, this is exactly why you need me on your team. These are the skills that I'm bringing to the table for your program. You need to have an understanding so that you can have those confident conversations. And the way I like to put it on the calls that I have with my Gold and Platinum subscribers is, if you tell somebody what to look for, they'll find it much more easily. And if you tell somebody what to look for and then you show them where to find it, you're making that person's job very, very easy. And that's exactly what you want. You want it to be easy for coaches to see why they should be interested in your athlete. So keep that in mind. What makes you a great recruit? Show it through your profile, say it in your messages, have it on the tip of your tongue when you're ready for a phone call. You are going to have better interactions, stronger interactions, more high impact interactions with coaches. I guess the question here is, how do you want coaches to perceive you? What's the story you want to tell? It's worth spending some time thinking about this before you just dive on in. You are going to have more effective conversations. And I want to speak for a moment about some resistance I often hear from athletes, where they say, I want my skills to speak for themselves. I don't want to brag. I don't want to seem overconfident. I don't want to seem cocky. This is, I think, kind of a trap when it comes to recruiting, because in many cases, those are good intuitions. Those are good values to want to say, I don't want to brag too much. I don't want to be overconfident. In many cases, that's fine. But this is recruiting. Again, tell the coach what to look for and show them where to find it. Make it easy for this coach to understand why they should be interested in your recruit. It's very, very important to have an understanding, to be able to communicate it, and to be able to demonstrate it. So that's the first piece here. The second piece is your colleges list. We talked about those three key steps, which was, hey, build and maintain your profile, build and maintain your list of schools, and have some conversations. So we're going through the second one here, your colleges list. And just like it's important to have an understanding of what makes you a good recruit or your athlete a good recruit, it's very important to have an understanding of what makes a school a good fit for your student. Is there a certain size school they're looking for, a certain division, a certain major they want to study? Do they want to go to school close to home or far away? Is the cost of the education very important? If you've spent the time to think about these things, it's going to be much easier to evaluate your list of schools and say, do the schools I'm looking at actually fit this? Are they realistic? Are they schools that we want to pursue further? Because if we had all the time in the world, you could just reach out to every school and have, write these great individual messages. The fact is, student athletes are some of the busiest people around. They've got their sport, they've got school, they've got social stuff, they've got, everything else that they have going on. Maybe they're working a job. They are busy, busy kids, and you are busy parents if you've got a high school kid. And so you don't have all the time in the world. You need to focus on the schools that are going to be the best fit. It's about prioritizing. And if you haven't thought about what your athlete is looking for in a school, you're not going to be able to effectively prioritize. So by this time, I think really 5 to 15 schools is where you want to be. If you're a rising junior, if you're starting your junior year, 10 to 15 schools. If you're going into your senior year, if you're kind of further along, 5 schools is a good place to be. If you're still just getting started, maybe you're a little behind, hey, 10 to 15 schools is okay. But I really recommend not going too much higher than that if you're, you know, in the latter half of your high school sports career, because you want to focus on those most important schools as opposed to casting a super wide net. You're going to have more effective conversations. You're going to have more confident conversations. And that's just what you need to stand out from the crowd. So, you know, it's better to have a personal narrow focus. Again, higher impact conversations, more confident. And it's also worth noting that here on your colleges list, as you work through the process, you know, as you have conversations with coaches, as you visit some campuses, as you research schools online, you know, your athlete will get a sense of what feels like a good fit and what doesn't. And your list can and should change as you have these conversations, as you're thinking about what schools are the best fit. So don't be afraid to update that list over time. Okay, so lastly, when it comes to recruiting conversations, I've got some really important, you know, exclamation marked things here. Be proactive, be consistent, be personal, be natural, be yourself. These are all things I hear time and time again when I speak with college coaches about what they want to hear from athletes. This is how you stand out. Don't guess what a coach wants to hear. Don't wait for coaches to come reaching out to you. Be proactive, consistent, personal, and natural. It's very important. You know, the medium is maybe a little less important than the idea of being proactive itself. You know, if you are more comfortable sending your messages through Captain You because it's easy, the templates are there, the contact info's in there, great. If you have a if you have a recruiting email that you set up and you'd prefer to use that, great. If you want to use social media to connect with coaches, great. That is all less important than what we talked about above, being proactive, consistent, personal, and being yourself. Coaches want to make sure that you're a good fit for their team, that you're motivated, that you're going to fit, you know, academically, athletically, culturally into their program. And so it's really important to kind of be straightforward about who you are or who your athlete is. Another idea here, when it comes to conversations, it is okay to try different methods of communication. You know, we talked about being consistent and following up and not being, you know, sending shorter messages more often. If you're having trouble with one medium, try something else. You know, try different things and see what works for you. At the end of the day, as long as you're being proactive, you're building exposure, you're building momentum, you're making progress. That's exactly what you want to get across. And again, don't be afraid to follow up. I keep reiterating on it because it's that important. Now, what to include? Hey, we've got a whole Captain You live session about exactly what to say in a message. If you want to check it out, go check it out on our last old our videos tab here on Facebook or on YouTube. But the summary, one, who are you and why should the coach care? You know, just like we talked about a couple slides ago, those key bullet point level things you want coaches to know, tell the coach. Be straightforward. Hey, coach, I'd be a great fit for your team because A, B, and C. Here's my video showing just that. Second piece, why are you interested in their program? You know, like we talked about with the colleges list slide, what is it about this school that is interesting to you or a good fit to you? Tell the coach about it. Let them know. Show them that you know who you're speaking with and that you're not just blasting this to every program in the country. It is far more impressive when a coach can say, wow, this athlete really took some time to point out exactly why my program or my university is a good fit for them. And then lastly, like we were talking about, always ask a question at the end. Always have a call to action, something you are trying to get from this coach. So those are the key things to consider when you're having these recruiting conversations. And really, you know, that's it for my slides today. You know, that at the end of the day, the key things to understand when you are getting into your junior senior year is, hey, we want to narrow that list to between 10 to 15 schools as a junior, 5 to 10 schools as a senior. We want to be super personal, super consistent with those schools. We want to make sure we're being proactive. We're pushing those conversations forward. We're demonstrating to coaches that we're motivated, that we want to earn a spot on their team, and we want to know what it's going to take. And, you know, if you're doing all that, you're going to be on the right track. So if you have any questions, if you want to learn more about Captain U, you can always reach me at Eric, Eric, at CaptainU.com. If you have ideas on what you would like me to cover in future presentations, go ahead and leave a comment. But thanks so much for watching, everybody. I hope this was helpful, and we will catch you next time.